Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So in today's video, I'll be showing you guys how to make the documentation command. I'll show you an example. Let me just use my Discord bot message, and then it will return this this endpoint. This embed, and then with all the properties that is fetched from the API. So I'll be showing you guys the API right now. Let me just put in the link. Okay, so this is the API. So basically, you just put your endpoint, you just put your query in here. And if I do message, as you can see here, it returns a embed. So what is embed? You can just place this embed in the send function, and then it will automatically send this, as you can see here, author name discord.js stable. As you can see, it's the same actually. Okay, enough of that. Now let's start coding the command. So I'll be using Axios for this. Let me just use the basic setup. Okay, if you haven't already, just do npm i-axios to install Axios. We will be using that to fetch data from the API. So we will require Axios. Alright. And then in the name, we can call this DJS. Or I can make an aliases. And then I'll make a array, and then docs. And then make sure you have the comma. So for the because this is an object and you need commas. Okay, so first you're gonna define query. My bad. Const query equals args.join. Okay, and then if there is no query, return message.channel. Message the reply. Please specify query. Okay, and then const URL equals to basically the URL. Let me just copy the URL. And then make sure it's template trolls, backticks, just put backticks, and then paste in the URL, and then remove message so you get this queue, and then equals. And then you're gonna put a dollar sign, and then you're gonna do encode URI component. So basically what this does is it changes spaces to 20 what is it called? Let me just show you. If I do like a message channel, if I do a space, it will change it to this. So yeah, just what encode URI component. Basically what it does, I don't know how to tell it, but it works something along those lines. Okay, then we already defined the URL. Then we can just do axios.get URL.then, and then data. So with Axios, when you want to access the data, you're gonna do a data.data. Instead of doing that, I'll straight away destructure it from the then itself. So I'm just gonna do the curly brackets and then data. Okay, and then we can do if data, and okay, let me just show you. If I do like a random query, and then it's gonna return null. So if data and data is not equals to null. Wait, actually, you just need this, I think. Yeah, if data, we're just gonna message channel send embed data. So we destructure and then we put the embed, and then in the embed there's data, and then we can that should be it, I think, for this command. We're just gonna save the file, okay, and then just start the bot up. So let's see if this works or not. So I can use either DJS or docs. So I'll be testing it with docs first. Why did I open File Explorer? Why docs? Message. Okay, I misspelled it. But yeah, it returns the data. So I can do it with same thing with DJS. It'll return the same thing because yes, it is an alias. Let me just do why docs message the author, and then it should say user because it's the user object. And then as you can see, type user. Alright, so this is basically how you do the Discord.js docs command. So you can easily access documentation within your bot rather than going to the website. And yeah, this is how you do it. Okay, if you like this video, make sure to leave a like. If you like content like this, make sure to hit the subscribe button. If you need help, make sure to join the support server, or you just want to join and talk with us, feel free to join the support server. Other than that, have a nice day. See you again on the next video. Bye.